Good morning all. In the previous class we have discussed about why we have to learn embedded systems, what are its advantages and research area in the application. Now today we will go into our first unit, okay, which is introduction to embedded systems. Now starting with what is an embedded system? Okay, the casual designed to perform a particular task. Okay. Now the definition wise, it is an electromechanical device, okay, which is developed to perform one particular task with the combination of hardware and software. Okay. So that's your definition. So an embedded system, it is an electronic and mechanical device designed to perform a specific function. It is very important not to use this specific function. Why? Because we can combine hardware and software in multiple ways. But to an embedded system, it is very specific, means task oriented. Like for example, let us take microwave oven. Okay, a task is to heat the food products or whatever inside the machine. So it will perform only one task. So that is a perfect example of an embedded system. So it is a combination of hardware and software to perform a specific function. That is your definition. Now, like we are emphasizing on a particular task. Likewise, the hardware also and the software, the program which we gonna write, is designed for a specific task. Okay. Like for example, the body structure of a microwave oven is very well different from the washing machine and the programming too. Now, for example, in case of microwave oven, the program will be of timer, or else in a new conventional microwave oven, we can choose different options like toast, bake, and all those things. Program also will be consisting of these factors. But coming to the washing machine, along with the timer, it has to detect, or else it has to recognize the white clothes and the allowance of the hot water, the heating of the cold water, and everything is there. The program is so different as well as the corporate one. So that's what we say, specialized to application domain. Okay, this is very important in this. And next, like why we are learning this one, as I said before, it is in our daily life. If you are in home, either in college or in any office, you are surrounded by the embedded systems. Okay, that is why this subject is a little bit more important. Okay, and you have to learn about it as being an engineer. Okay, now first let us differentiate what is a general purpose system and embedded system. Okay. To our common convenience, I am taking these two as a primary example. Like a general purpose system, I will take as our normal PC or desktop or any laptop. Now coming to embedded system, I can take washing machine, microwave oven and whatnot, mobile phones and all those things. Okay. See, what are the main different characteristics of this one? Okay. Now, as you all know, computers, we can write programs, we can install the programs, okay, and you can perform different tasks. Now, coming to this embedded product, for example, in this case, we can only wash the clothes. We cannot cook our food in this one. Like, for that time, we will have a separate machine. That is one difference. This is working wise. Now, if you go interior, like how this has been developed, what are the operating systems that these two carry, memory size, processors, okay, that will make these two so different, and we will be looking into that one by one. Okay. Now, see, this is the main difference in which I am differentiating the embedded system from the general purpose system. The main factors are like contents, operating systems, alterations, key factors in deciding whether how to choose these devices: power consumption, response time, and execution. Okay. Now coming to the contents. Let's see. Every device is made up of hardware and software in the present world. Okay. Now how we are choosing these one. Now coming to the general purpose systems, the hardware will be and the software will be for general purpose, and operating system is for the general purpose. Means that we can modify. For example, if you take any system, not a laptop, I'm talking about a desktop. Okay, you can reconfigure. For example, if you want to change the RAM, you can do it. If you want to change the hard disk, you can do it. You can insert the DVD writer and whatnot. Okay, it is for the general purpose. It will be for multiple tasks. That the laptop can be used for recording, plus to watch movies and whatnot. Likewise, the operating system should be compatible for these tasks. Okay. Now, the operating system also, you can modify, not the kernel, but you can install different applications, right? Like we do, install all the, what you say, new applications that you want to run. For example, Adobe Photoshop and everything. So there is a capability of changing the operating or installing new programs in the general purpose system. Now coming to the embedded, no, it is only for made for one purpose, that is to perform a specific task. In case of, for example, let us take the washing machine, it is to wash the clothes. Now we call alternate, or you can use it for other purposes, as well as we are not available, it is not readily available to change the program also. So we have to open, and if you change, everything will be great. Why? Because the manufacturer comes with the production of the operating system, which it has, or else with the program. Why? Because it's a trade secret for their company, so they won't allow it to change. Only the specific persons who are trained in such domain can perform those tasks. Okay, so that is one main difference. Now, as I said before, operating system also, so it will be for specific tasks. For example, in case of washing machine, it doesn't require any operating system as a matter of fact. It just need a small microcontroller which runs a program, which detects the timing sequence and everything that is fine. Okay. But coming to the computer, we need a little bit of operating system, which should decide which task has to be performed and everything. Okay, that is different. Alteration, as I said before, is not reprogrammable. Coming to the embedded system, whereas the general purpose system, we can change, we can install new programs. Okay, now key factors. When you are trying to buy a general purpose laptop, so what we look into? Graphic card, okay, RAM, and its fastness, and capability of doing other tasks, multiple tasks at a parallel, right? But coming to the embedded system, we'll be looking into, okay, what's its performance, reliability, and things like that. So these two differ in that way. So that those are the deciding factors. Faster is better, is reliable is better. Now coming to power consumption, you don't worry about how much the power it consumes in case of laptops or a system. But while you buying embedded products, there is an emphasis on power consumption. For example, your refrigerator. Like I tell you have been observed, there is a power rating, the 5-star, 4-star, 3.5. That shows, okay, it consumes. If you have 3.5-star refrigerator, consumes more power than the 5-star. Okay, so we will be looking into these factors. Response time, for us, your laptop, depends upon how many programs you have installed and everything. So it is not time critical, can take its full time. But coming to embedded devices, most of it is very time critical. It has to finish its time within certain amount of time. Okay, so deviation is not acceptable. So that is the response time. Execution, deterministic, and non deterministic. And coming to this one, I will explain it later. going deep into it, but let me tell you, see, most of the inventions that we do have in our present world is designed for some other purpose and we are using for some other purpose. For example, let me tell you, the microwave oven which you are using right now is designed for what? To produce a radio heat at a certain area, but now we are using for food. Likewise, this embedded system is designed for some other purpose, but it is useful for many other things. The first purpose that we have used is Apollo Guidance Computer. So it acts as an interface between the computer which is stationed around the ground stations and the satellite or an astronaut which is in the same space. Okay? It transfers the data. So he can communicate with the ground station. They have all these numbers. Okay, as you can see, we use a picture of the Apollo guidance computer. Now, as you mentioned, we use one product for multiple purposes, right? And this is another example. But I can say this is the first mass-produced embedded system. Okay, which is also a guidance system which we call 9891. It helps, the PC helps guide to its destination. Okay, as I said before, most of the inventions came out of war. So this one a good example to guide the missiles to its destination. Okay, that is its major purpose, the first purpose. So later the developments have been made into it, like we are reducing the size of it. As see, that is the beauty of this electronics, as I said, embedded system has its own branch, but let me tell you, the developments in other branches like industries, like in VLSI, okay. So, what happened? I believe you know the history of the ICs, right? As the generation progressed, the compactness is increased, number of transistors embedded into the ICs are increased, so the size of these controllers also increased. So, it is interrelated. The development in one stream affects the other streams also. That is the beauty of the electronics. Now, that's your brief history of embedded system. Now, second thing, like we have the classifications of embedded system. See, as I said, it's same. What we are talking is same, but we are looking into different perceptions. The first one will differentiate based upon generations. Okay, how generation by generation the use of this embedded system has been changed, okay, and then will be differentiated based upon complexity, okay, smart devices, big robots, industrial machines, so those are also embedded systems, but we are differentiating in terms of its complexity, size, and the hardware components, software components used in those things, okay. Now, deterministic behavior, see, based upon behavior, like if say event trigger or time trigger devices, coming to the first one, based upon generations, like as I said before, these every development is interrelated. First generation of an embedded system, what they are using 4-bit microcontroller, small devices like your control unit, okay, telephone keypad, telephone keypads. So these are the first generation of embedded systems, and apart from the missiles and all those things which we have discussed. So, step motor controller, like for example, it has to work for a certain amount of rotations. So, those program can be embedded into a small microchip and we can use this one. That is your first generation. Okay. Now, second generation, okay, as the axis has been increased, the number of pins of those increased, so microcontrollers come in 16 bit pins.